Among its other claims, the business card of Mansur Elisha boasted that all roads lead to Aspen, and that meant the Hotel Jerome. Old-timers say that the Hotel Jerome was the center of Aspen activities during the 1930s and 40s. In these Depression years, and through the turmoil of World War II, the Jerome was the center of the community, not only for guests, but for Aspen residents as well. Guests at the hotel in those days say the Jerome provided first-hand knowledge of life in Aspen. There were many permanent guests who sought refuge from their snowed-in ranches. Often those wintering there were greater in number than nightly customers. The hotel was a refuge in a storm, a place to gather for a warm meal. It was a dominant part of the character of the town, a focal point for community. The hotel boasted formal dining rooms, a bar, buffet, soda fountain, and of course, a barber shop. The Jerome was built in 1889 by Silver Baron Jerome B. Wheeler. He gave it up for back taxes in 1909, 16 years after silver had lost its value. A traveling salesman named Mansur Elisha bought the Jerome in 1911. And with his wife Lulu, he made it both home and business. The Elishas had three children. Lawrence, born in 1907, was their only son, and he helped his parents in the day-to-day operations of the hotel. The Elishas were considered pillars of the community and gracious hosts, and Lawrence learned through experience how to accommodate guests. The hotel was extravagant in its size and required the entire family to operate it smoothly. There was plenty of work for everyone when guests flocked there for formal dinners. Peggy Rowland.
Mansur was owner of the hotel when I was a child, and Lulu was the cook, and she did plain food, but it was delicious, and we went there often for Sunday dinner at 35 cents. It was great, and they were both real nice, homey people.
Lawrence learned the hotel business from his parents, and he gradually took more and more of the responsibilities. Svea Elder, a schoolmate a year younger than Lawrence, pictured here on the left, became his wife in 1925. Like Mansur and Lulu, they also had their children in the hotel, three boys and a girl, Don, Lowell, MJ, and later Ingrid. The job of raising a family and running the hotel was hard, but Lawrence and Svea were up to the task. They took over management in 1935, and when skiers discovered Aspen, a new clientele had arrived. Elizabeth Pepka came in 1939.
We had to plow our way through snowdrifts, and the road was hidden except for barbed wire fences that now and then showed the way. The driver of the car was Laurence Elisha. We drove up before the Jerome Hotel eventually, and in the wind was shaking one bare electric light bulb. This man in the front jumped out, seized our bags, lifted them into the hotel, ran to the end of the lobby where the safe was in the fireplace. He pulled some keys off the hooks and said that he was the owner of the hotel.
Lawrence and Svea helped set the tone for Aspen visitors with their hospitality and their diligence. Thanks to them, the hotel remained a centerpiece for the town, always open to customers, always ready for business.
Responsibility to keep the place open, keep the doors open, keep the bills paid, and keep the place running fell on those two individuals. They did it all.
Their son, M.J. Elisha.
I think if the Jerome had not been open during, say, the period from 1925 through 1945, Aspen would be a different place than certainly is today.
Built in a style of grandeur and elegance, the Jerome reflected the dreams of Aspen during wealthier times. The Elishas maintained that elegance because the hotel represented Aspen, but more important, it represented them.
Well, you walked in, and on the right side, and I think it's special occasions now, was what they called the buffet. They served ice cream sodas, and also you could get a shot, as they called it, in the ice cream soda. So it was sort of a mixture of a ice cream parlor and a bar. Mona Frost played the piano, and Sis Ritchie played the violin, or Frances Heron. And there was music on Sunday nights. It still was only 35 cents.
Visiting skiers brought life to the hotel. And for the really adventuresome, that drink made of bourbon and milkshakes, the Aspen Crud, became popular. When the 10th Mountain Division came to town, it was a major event. Walter Pepke leased the hotel in 1946, and it was repainted white. With its new coat of paint, the hotel stood out from the town as a focal point. Skiers are drawn by increasing numbers, and some of today's residents reminisce about getting their start as bartenders, doormen, and receptionists.
This photograph was taken in 1951 when Jim Adams and I were bellhops at the Hotel Jerome.
John DeRemus.
Laurence Elisha was a wonderful guy. I never saw a guy work so hard. Even though he used to own the hotel and sold it to the Aspen Company, he always behaved as if it was his hotel and his responsibility. One of the tricks Lawrence had in his hat was we were always having trouble with the heat. The old radiators would always spit and spat, and it was either too hot or too cold, and we bellhops got a lot of complaints. He taught us, just go out and get a piece of snow and stick it on top of the thermostat, and that would cure it every time, and it worked.
Lawrence and Svea knew all the quirks of the hotel business, but their spirit went well beyond the front door.
Both Lawrence and Svea were very instrumental in any project that was going on in the city.
Albert Bishop.
Whether it was TV or Elks or Eagles or the Fire Protection District or Ski Corporation, Ski Club, they were right in the middle of everything.
But basically they didn't have a whole lot to help anybody with except a room and a meal. It was a matter of good friendship, good feeling, and making things work. If it solved the problem, that was an easy thing to do. I think they did contribute to the growing Aspen experience through a period of difficult times.
Those difficulties are blurred by today's affluence, again reflected by the hotel's grandeur. But those times should never be forgotten. They forged a tight-knit community, the spirit of which was personified by the Elisha family and their Hotel Jerome.